This video explains how to make a chatbot conversation history accessible. We'll explain why the conversation must be navigable and why we need to make it work with the mouse and keyboard. We'll use the CSS property overflow-y to make a section element scroll vertically with overflowing content, and add the tabindex attribute to make the element appear in the keyboard focus sequence. All users need to be able to navigate through the entire conversation history at any point when talking to a bot. But if we only allow navigation via the mouse, keyboard users will be unable to see the history. So we need to build in extra keyboard support. And when we build in the keyboard support, we also need to make the element appear in the keyboard tab sequence. If we look at the code, every conversation is rendered in a section element which alternates between messages from the bot and messages from the user. Section elements can help a screen reader user by providing better context than generic div elements. In essence, a section element means this content is special, and within a screen reader, a user can usually navigate to named regions on the page. Every section element is rendered within a further section element, which is the chatbot conversation window, and this contains all of the conversation history. We've set this to a fixed height of 150 pixels and the overflow property set to hidden. The conversation window has content which overflows the fixed height dimensions, but because the overflow property is set to hidden, we're unable to see further messages. This is changed by removing the overflow property and adding the property overflow-y with a value of scroll. This means when the content overflows the section element's fixed height, a vertical scroll bar appears. And we can scroll through the entire conversation history. Even though we've now made the entire conversation history viewable, a user navigating with the keyboard won't be able to scroll the conversation history, as section elements don't receive keyboard focus. Add the attribute tabindex and the value of 0 to the parent section containing all of the children elements. This makes it focusable from the keyboard, and a value of 0 makes it appear in the regular keyboard ordering sequence of the other focusable page elements. We've covered why the conversation history must be navigable and how to go about it. We used the CSS property overflow-y to make a section element accommodate for overflowing content, and we used the tabindex attribute to make the section element appear in the keyboard sequence. When the conversation overflows, a vertical scroll bar appears. Adding tabindex to this section element then makes the element appear in the keyboard tab sequence, and the up and down arrow keys are used to scroll through the container. Check the descriptions below for background information, WCAG 2's success criteria, links to the transcript and completed HTML source on GitHub. And remember to like and share.